Now exercise 38, question number 4. What smallest number has to be added to 4200 to make it a perfect square number? So here the question is just opposite that than in the previous video. The question over there was what smallest number needs to be subtracted to make the given number perfect square. Here, what number has to be added to make the given number perfect square? So from this, we know that the given number is not a perfect square. That's why we need to add or subtract something to make it a perfect square. So if we find the square root of the given number, since it is not a perfect square, there will be remainder. When any number given is not a perfect square, we get a remainder. So first we will try to find out the square root and see what is the remainder. Now 42. Which two similar numbers when multiplied gives nearest? 6 6 is 36, 7 7 is 49, exceeds 42. So we will take 6 6 is 36. The remainder is 6 over here, and take down both the numbers at a time. Now here you have done 6 into 6. The next divisor, with what you will divide 600? That is not given in this type of sum. With what, in any kind of division sum, you need a divisor and a dividend. But here no divisor is given, and each step you have to make the divisor. So 6, 6 you have done. Here you will do 6 plus 6, 12. Fix it. Whatever you do from the previous step, you have to fix it. And with 12, you have to take a number, say 123, and multiply with the same number. 12 is fixed, only this part can change. If you take 3, multiply with 3. If you take 124, you have to multiply with 4. And in this way, you have to find which will divide or which can be nearest to 600. So 3 3 is a 9, 3 2 is a 6, 3 1 is a 3, 369. 4 4 is a 16, 1 4 2 is a 8, 1 9, 4 1 is a 4, 496. So let us try with 125 also. 5 5 is a 25, 12. 625. So 125 into 5 gives you a higher number. Okay, so 525 into 5 gives a higher number you cannot take. So you will take 124 into 4, that gives you 496. So what is the remainder over here? ₹104. So we are getting a remainder. That means this is not a perfect square, proved. Now the question over here is like the previous sum, because here you need to find the smallest number. But there is a difference in the question that has to be added. If the question was what should be subtracted, then 104, the remainder, has to be subtracted to get the next perfect square number, or to get the nearest perfect square number. But here the question is added, so the technique will be different. What you have to do, how to find what should be added? Whatever is the quotient, you have to take, so here the quotient is 64, you have to add 1 to that, so it is 65, and you have to take its whole square. Whole square means multiply 2 times. So the quotient plus 1, that is the next number, 65, whose whole square you need to find out. That means 65 into 65, So 65 into 65 gives 4225. So 4225 is the next perfect square number. So we know the next perfect square number is 4225 minus 4200. You will get 25. So from the next perfect square number, we have to subtract the given number and we have to check how much we need to add. So with 4200, if we add 25, then only we can go to the next perfect square number, 4225. So we know that in the question it was given something has to be added with 4200 to give the next perfect square number. So 4200 we will find by division method. When we are getting remainder, it is proved it is not a perfect square. Then quotient, whenever the question is what should be added, what you have to do, take the next number. Quotient, if it is 64, you will take 65. Quotient, if it is 63, you will take 64. And that number's whole square is the next perfect square number. Now, once you know the next perfect square number, which comes after 4200, that is 4225, you can straight away see that 25 must be added to go to the next perfect square number, or you can do it by this method. From the perfect square, next perfect square number, if you subtract, you will get the difference. How much should be added? So the answer is 25 should be added to get the perfect square number. And here, please don't write PS, it is perfect square number.